to blog post at blog.isallaboutmath.com, we wrote about a new incredible computer program called Phun, P-H-U-N, freely available at www.phun.at. This computer program is defined by his creator, Emil Ehrenfeld from Sweden, as a 2D physics sandbox. Phun is a virtual physics reality simulator. Imagine a computer program where you can build objects, and these objects have mass and gravity that can add upon them, or collisions between objects can also happen. You can build objects of different shapes and sizes, and also with different physical properties. You may also be able to change what objects collide with what other object by keeping them in the same collision group. Since Phun is 2D, being able to set groups of collisions is a necessary property. You are also allowed to change the weight of an object, bounciness, friction, and color. Naturally, this is a simplification of all the physical attributes an object can have, but is the necessary minimum to produce a more or less convincing physical simulation. The brush could be used for creating arbitrarily shaped objects. You may also create circles and boxes, chains and springs. The fixate is used to attach things to the background or to each other, and the hinge have a dual purpose. It can be used as just a hinge or as a motor. Phun can be used as a creation tool for experimenting with some mechanism or mechanical interactions. In a way, Phun is similar to Lego blocks, but with Phun you can create your own parts. If you visit the Phun site at www.phun.at, you will find many examples of Phun scenes created by multiple people from all over the world. When you build a Phun scene, it's like you're building graphically a program where each component you create have some physical properties attached, because you need to draw these objects. It's almost like you are programming Phun. So this process of building a scene, you are actually programming Phun. And by extension, a Phun programmer is he who creates a scene. Once you run the program, and that you do by hitting play, you could have gravity add on all the objects at once. It is actually very entertaining to see some of these scenes created by other people. Even more Phun to be able to create one of these scenes yourself. Many of them are rockets and tanks or small moving things. Some other Phun creators have dedicated their time to create ingeniously intricate mechanisms. We are still in complete awe by some of the mechanical things that people have created with Phun. Between those prolific creators, I have found Livio Succa from Turin, Italy. I believe Livio's creations deserve more attention for his ingenuity and mathematical flavor. Let me show a binary mechanical counter created by Livio. The objective of this machine is to count the balls falling and collect the balls back in an infinite counting loop. The main counting mechanism is a mechanical latch. An electronic latch is a circuit which has two stable states and thereby can store one bit of information. We can also create a mechanical latch, and this adds similarly to a balance where the pivoting point is reversed. The numbers in this case have dual function. One is to inform us of the stay of the latch and also acting as stoppers for the balancer. On the left side, we can see the ball feeding mechanism, and the green bar with a slight inclination acts as the collector of the balls rolling slowly towards the left. You may also appreciate the mechanism for translating circular motion into linear upward motion on the left side. This mechanism brings back memories of the mechanism that provide steam locomotive with motive power in times past, and a scene like this could be useful to learn about the binary numerical system, that is, a numerical system that uses only two digits and also used by digital computers. Here is another version of the same scene, but this time it's got a mechanism that translates the numbers from binary to decimal. This other version places balls in buckets, and the number of balls in each bucket correspond to the numbers in the fourth row of Pascal's triangle, that is 1, 4, 6, 4, 1. One, for example, may also think about creating machines that put balls on buckets. Liviu got nice solutions for a machine that produces the Fibonacci sequence 1, 1, 2, 3, 5. Notice how the recursive equation Fn equal Fn minus 1 plus Fn minus 2 with F in 1 equal to 1 and F in 2 equal to 1 is executed mechanically with the use of a balance that compares the weight of the prior two buckets to the weight of the following bucket. The sequence of triangular numbers is obtained by a similar procedure 1, 3, 6, and also the sequence of natural numbers 1, 2, 3. A little bit harder is to obtain the sequence of primes using a mechanical mechanism. This mechanical mechanism simulates the ideas of the sieve of Eratosthenes to obtain the sequence 2, 3, 5, 7. And you may also find simulations for the Pascal line, a machine created by Blaise Pascal. Let me show last this wonderful mechanical machine that is able to multiply two-digit numbers and produce the result in the decimal system. We believe Phun will be a source of inspiration for students and teachers, and it will be useful in the motivation and instruction of mathematics, physics, computer science, mechanical engineering, and electronic. Phun is opening a new universe of interactive learning, and should I dare say, Phun. If you like to play, run, or modify some of the scenes displayed here, visit our site blog.isallaboutmath.com for the links.